Hello, everyone. I'm Drew Barrymore, and I'm here to induct the Go-Go's into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. This is such an honor, and honestly, it was really easy to do because the Go-Go's had been in my personal Hall of Fame since I was 6 years old. In fact, if you told tiny me that I'd be up here introducing my heroes into the most notable rock club in human history, I would say, well, I will do my best to honor these women. Do you remember the first record that you ever got? If you do, shout it out to me. You know what mine was? It was Beauty and the Beat. It was my very first record. Beauty and the Beat blew the doors of my life off. It opened me up to a whole new dimension. I dropped the needle and I felt instantly connected to the punk pulse of this record. It sounded like pure possibility. It rattled up my walls and straight through to my heart. I spent hours staring at that cover and the backside, all of them in the bathtub. The coolest girls in the world taking a spa day in cool girl heaven. It was always a party for guys for so long, but these girls, they were crashing it. I sang along to This Town and I felt invited to the party, and I loved that these girls were from my hometown. I was a West Hollywood kid and the Go-Go's were born out of LA punk, and they played their first show at Mask, a club in the basement of the Pussycat. Oh yeah, if you were in LA in the 70s, you know what the Pussycat is. It's an adult theater. And it was just a stone's throw away from my childhood bedroom. And it was in that bedroom that I wore that record out. And it took one album and I was hooked. I was gaga for the Go-Go's. And damn, their outfits, God, they were incredible. I mean, take one look at me in the 80s, you'll see where I got my inspiration. Yes. And imagine meeting Belinda Carlisle when you're kind of dressed like a little mini Belinda Carlisle. That was me in 1984. I was just 9 years old, looking at my hero. And just last night, I danced with my nine-year-old daughter, Olive, and her sister, Frankie, to We Got the Beat. And I felt like my whole life came full circle knowing that I was coming here. They changed my life. They made me believe in things I didn't think were possible. And tonight, we're going to show them how they changed the world. 40 years of making music, countless world tours, selling out 8 shows at the Whiskey, playing the Bowl, the Garden, getting tanked, and playing SNL for 60 million, opening for the Stones, influencing so many kick-ass bands to come. And that's just a tiny sampler of this band's legacy. And it doesn't even touch what they muscled through in their Wild Chapters. And trust me, I know a thing or two about Wild Chapters. I always thought the Go-Go's was such a perfect name for that band. So full of kinetic energy. It fits their music and their spirit and mine too. And you know what? You always have to just go for it. So I looked up the word go in the dictionary, and there are so many definitions. To move on a course, my favorite definition of the word go was to proceed without delay in an often thoughtless and reckless manner. Now my childhood fantasy is fulfilled, but it isn't about me. This is as true blue of a love letter from their biggest fan. from the first band I ever loved. Here's a look at the Go-Go's. It is my privilege to induct into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Belinda Carlisle, Jane Wiedlin, Charlotte Caffey, Gina Schock, and Kathy Valentine. Everyone give it up for the Go-Go's!
Oh,
Thank you, Drew. Woo. I'm Kathy Valentine, and I can speak for all the Go-Go's when I say we are so happy and excited and proud to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Our band has been at different times like the most rinky-dink traveling circus you could ever imagine, like a snarling wolf pack, and very much like family. That we are a sisterhood and women is significant. We became a commercially successful band, except we started at the bottom where all rock and roll bands start. And our music found its way into our fans' hearts and into their lives. By honoring our historical contribution, the doors to this establishment have opened wider. And the Go-Go's will be advocating for the inclusion of more women. Because here is the thing, there would not be less of us if more of us were visible. So, to all the little girls, the teenagers, the young ladies, any woman, any age out there in the world who is wanting and hoping and dreaming to be heard, hopefully loudly, with guitars and drums and basses and your unique, wonderful voices, the Go-Go's are here to say, dream, baby, dream, and rock on!
Hi, you guys, I'm Gina. And I can't believe. I want to thank all of our families, especially our moms and dads who supported us and allowed us to follow our dreams. They were there from the start. Our family of musicians who are out there, you're everywhere. You are part of us, we are part of you. Oh. And now I'm going to introduce our fabulous singer, Babe Carlisle.
We have had so much love and guidance in our 43 years together. Ginger Canzoneri, our first manager, who was like our mom. Radford Cobb, who was always kind, sweet, and smart. Bruce Patron, somewhere up there. We love you. And also our manager, Mike Hayes. And of course, our cheerleader and manager, Art Cisneros. The next person is Charlotte Caffey, guitarist extraordinaire.
Hello.
Thank you.
When we were a band unable to get a record deal, IRS Records took a chance on us. Miles Copeland, you are a mad genius. Our first producer, Richard Goddard, heard something in us that many other people didn't. And our beloved crew, Chris Arredondo and Travis Casper Bauer, thank you for taking care of us on stage and on the road. Love and thanks to you all. And now, last but not least, the iconic Jane Wiedlin.
Now, gee whiz. Well, we've been at it for 43 years so far. Go figure. Anyways, in this millennium, I don't think anyone has had more of an impact on our band's career or legacy than the director, Allison, Jesus Christ. Allison Elwood, who created our documentary, The Go-Go's. She really understood us and introduced the world to a band, you know, that really was kind of maybe fading away or whatever, and then she brought it all right back, and we're so grateful to her. But the people we're most grateful to of all are the fans who have been with us for over four decades. And they keep coming back. We love you guys. We wouldn't be anything without you. And thank you so much for this honor. It's just unbelievable. Head explosion.